Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Now in this video I'm going to explain you about kingdom fungi. Okay, the third kingdom. Okay, already we have studied about the prokaryotes and they are present in the kingdom Monera. Okay, then eukaryotes, that is kingdom Protista, we have studied in the previous video, and now the third one is the kingdom fungi. So kingdom fungi, they are the multicellular one. Up to here Protista, that was unicellular, but now starting from the multicellular organism, that is the cells in the organism with cell wall. Okay, so basically plant is having the cell wall, plant cell is having the cell wall, whereas in animal cells no cell wall is there in the on the cell. So again, this the organism which are having the cell wall, they are of two kinds. One is those who are able to perform the photosynthesis, they belong to the kingdom Plantae, and those who are unable to do photosynthesis just because they don't have the chlorophyll, they are belonging to the group or kingdom called the fungi. So now we will study about fungi. Now children, here we will see the characteristic features of fungi. That fungi are simple, non-green, multicellular eukaryotes, except yeast, which are unicellular. Okay, or yeast is a unicellular organism. Okay, that is the exception, and rest are the multicellular one. Okay, they grow on dead and decaying organic matter. That's why they are the saprophytes. They are non-photosynthetic. That means they don't have the chlorophyll. So most of them are saprotrophs, as they feed on the dead and decaying organic matter, while some are parasites. Okay, so some are saprotrophs and some are parasites. Some parasites means what? They are living on the living host. Okay, they are drawing food from them. Okay, so examples are mucor, mushroom, rhizopus, that is the bread mold. Okay, present on the bread. Then aspergillus is there, and penicillium. Okay, some more features you can see. The body of multicellular filamentous fungus is called the mycelium, which is composed of several thread like structures called the hyphae. So if you see this figure, that is the structure of a fungal hyphae. You can see this is the moist bread. Okay, and these are the rhizoidal hyphae. Okay, they act as the roots. Okay, then this are the stem, stolon, it is known as stolon, act as a stem. Then here sporangiophore, erect hyphae, and sporangium, these are having the spores. Okay, they carry the spores and they are the reproductive bodies. Okay, so their cell walls are formed from the chitin, not from the cellulose. Okay, chitin is much harder than the cellulose. They reproduce by spore formation, and some fungi live in the symbiotic, that is a mutual dependent. That means for something others will be dependent on them, and they are dependent on others for some other things. So that is called the mutual relationship. Okay, symbiotic relationship with blue green algae, and as it is known as the lichens. Okay, or lichens also you can say. So this is the one fungus and one algae combine, and they give the symbiotic association, and they are known as the lichens or the lichens. Now moving towards the another topic, or the studying about the another organism in the kingdom fungi, they are the molds. Molds are saprophytic fungi growing on dead organic matter, rotten fruits, leather goods and breads, and other edibles. Okay, they are form fine, fluffy and cottony mass. Rhizopus and mucor are the two common bread molds. Okay, so bread molds are there. The cottony mass of both rhizopus and mucor consists of mycelium, which is made up of branch hyphae, and the cell wall is made up of fungal cellulose. Okay, so here stolon run parallel, as I have told you before, and then rhizoidal hyphae, they act as a root. Okay, and sporangiophore, and they carry the spores inside. And here you see bread molds are saprophytes. They secrete digestive enzymes on the stale bread. the moist bread is there, you might have noticed that they are having the lots of fungus on it, on them. So they, why is it so? Because in that bread there will be glucose, and that will be started digested by the fungus. Okay, bread molds use oxygen during respiration. That means that they are the aerobics one. You can see, children, these are the tomatoes on which this white substance is grown. So basically they are the rhizopus. Okay, they are the rhizopus, and they can infect other organisms also, I mean the other products also which are kept with them. You can see this picture. See, and it's very common at your home if you are being little careless about the vegetables. So what will happen? They will start growing and spoiling it. Okay, so these all are the rhizopus. Okay, here you can see the stale bread is there, and this is the structure which is present on the bread. That is called a bread mold. Okay, they are also having the sporangiophores. Okay, and rhizoidal hyphae is there. Okay, rhizoidal hyphae. So hyphae, and this is, you can see that this, they are able to digest the starch in the form of glucose. Okay, they will turn it into glucose, and then they can survive on the bread mold, bread. Okay, so that's why they are known as a bread mold. And now we will study about the good fungi and the bad fungi. Okay, so good fungi, obviously they will be the useful one, that's why they are good for us. And bad ones, that means those who creates diseases. Okay, those who are responsible for the diseases. So here, useful fungi, some fungi are used in food industry, medicine industry, and the agriculture. Okay, food industry, medicine, and other industries, and the agriculture. So starting from the food industry, mushrooms. So starting from the mushroom, you all know mushroom, and you all have eaten also, obviously, that pizza. Remember, they are having the mushrooms. Okay, and mushroom, since it is very rich in proteins and vitamins, they are cultivated on the commercial level. How you are getting those mushrooms in the market? Packed properly and stored properly. Okay, so they are the agaricus and the morcella. These are the mushrooms which are edible one. Okay, and they are cultivated for the business profit. Okay, then another is the yeast. Yeast contains vitamin B complex and vitamin E, and it is used in the bakeries to make the dough soft and puffy, for making breads, and in the beverages for making alcohol and the wine. So different kinds of yeast are responsible for different productions. Okay, so basically this yeast is available in the market, and those who are baking the cakes and the breads and all, they are using these yeast. Okay, nowadays you all are also making cakes and breads at home, so there also you might be using these yeast. Okay, then one more thing I want to tell you, how the yeast are able to make the dough soft and fluffy, because they keep on respiring inside, and when they respire, the carbon dioxide gas is released. Okay, so that makes the air spaces in between. Okay, so that's why when you cut the cake, you can see that air spaces are in between and they are fluffy. Okay, more air spaces are in between, more fluffy will be the cake. Now children, another milk product is cheese. Okay, you know the flavors of cheese, different flavors you are having of cheese, and you like also there are that slice also, cheese spread is also there, cheese slice is there, then mozzarella cheese is there, so many different varieties, and they are having flavors also. So it is just because of different kinds of fungi which are used for the flavoring purpose. Okay, so mucor, aspergillus, and penicillium is there for the flavoring purpose and also for the ripening of the cheese. You might have heard about the penicillin. Okay, penicillin is the wonder drug. Okay, and it was discovered by Alexander Fleming in 1929. You might have studied in GK also. Okay, so Fleming observed that some bacteria growing in the culture were destroyed by an accidental contamination with the mold Penicillium notatum. So what he saw during the experiment in his laboratory, he saw that accidentally when Penicillium notatum get mixed with the another bacteria, then they have spoiled the bacteria or they have suppressed the growth of the bacteria. So from there he has extracted out the medicine called the penicillin. Okay, so this is called the wonder drug. Now next area where the fungi are used, there are the medicines. So they are for the production of antibiotics. This fungi are used which kill the microorganisms which are present inside our body. Okay, so there are 25 types of antibiotics and are commercially produced by molds, okay, for the business purpose. Another, synthesis of proteins and fats. So protein are synthesized by the yeast, whereas fats are synthesized by the penicillium and the aspergillus. That means the formation of protein and the fat molecules. Okay, so that is through these two fungi. See, the fungi are very important for the agriculture. Okay, how? In the field of agriculture, what they do, they are very much helpful for increasing the soil fertility. Now, how they increase the soil fertility? As you know, they are the saprophytic one. Okay, they are unable to make their food, so they are dependent on dead and decomposed materials. Okay, organic materials. So obviously, who are the dead and decomposed one? Decaying one, they are the dead bodies of the animals and the plants. And what they do, they convert their complex organic compounds into simpler inorganic compounds such as nitrites, nitrates, sulfates, phosphates, etc. So here you can see, just like bacteria, they are also responsible for the soil fertility. They increase the soil fertility. In the same way, here also the fungi do. What is that? Soil fungi absorb inorganic salts and prevent them from being lost from the soil leaching. And some fungi control and prevent spread of other disease causing organisms in the soil. So here three things they are doing. First thing, they are changing the complex organic compound, the dead and decayed one, into simpler inorganic compounds, and then they get mixed. It get mixed, nitrate, nitrite, sulfates, phosphate, because alone bacteria is not sufficient for the increasing of this soil fertility. So here they both together and inside the soil, they increases the fertility of the soil because they are increasing the mineral amount. And another, soil fungi absorb inorganic salts, and another is they control and prevent the spread of other disease causing microorganisms. Now that is over. That is the useful fungi or the good fungi which were responsible for the many fields. That is a food industry, they are very much helpful, and then medicine, chemical industry, and then their role in agriculture is also there. But there are few fungi which are harmful also. So those harmful ones are obviously, they will create the diseases in the body of plant and the animals also, and some are responsible for the spoilage of food. So with this you are very much familiar. Only I want to explain you a little bit, though these all things are present in your environment, in your surroundings. And basically the harmfulness you will see during the rainy season on, or when the weather is moist, okay, in the moisture. Okay, now here you can see that human diseases like ringworm, ring shaped lesions are there on the skin. So basically fungus can produce skin diseases, skin problems. Then vaginal yeast infection, that means the internal infection will be there. Then because that surface is a moist one, and athlete's foot is basically the problem of the toes. Okay, the in between the toes there will be the fungal infection. Okay, similarly there are some problems of the inside the ear also. When you are taking bath and after bathing, you are not wiping your ears properly, then inside, as the water will remain inside, the moisture will be also remain inside, then what happens, then slowly and gradually the fungus will start growing and that will give you severe pain. Another is the mold spores cause allergies as respiratory problem and sneezing. Many allergic problems are just because of the spores which are present into the environment, okay, because they are spread through the wind, okay. So during the, especially during the March season, or when there will be harvesting process keep on going, so that time this respiratory problems are there, a kind of allergies are there, which will lead to the continuous sneezing, okay. So this is called human diseases they are responsible for. Then some plant diseases are also caused by the harmful fungi, and they are the white rust of crucifers, downy mildew of grapes, late blight of potato, rust in wheat and smut in maize. Okay, so these all are the cereal crops are there, they are also getting infected because of the fungi. Then spoilage of food. Penicillium, aspergillus and molds like mucor and rhizopus spoil our fruits, vegetables, meat, dairy products, etc. as I have shown you before. Okay. Then spoilage of leather goods. Leather goods, you know, they are also the organic substances. Okay, because they are the leather are coming from the dead organisms. Okay. So leather made shoes, bags, purses, belts, covers of many articles, they are destroyed just because of this fungus only. Okay, they start growing on it. Why? Because they are made up of organic products, organic things, organic substances. Okay, the leather, you know that they are getting from the animal skin. So what happened, and even the bags and purses, these all are, so you will find that some powdery substances are spread over it, and once it is there, then you cannot repair it properly, okay, as it was before. So this, they are responsible, the fungi are responsible for the spoilage of leather goods. So students, hope you all have understood the topics. If you have any doubt or question, you can ask in the comment section below. Please like, share it with your classmates, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you.